Hi, my name's Merlin. Welcome to tip number 3 of our helpful tips, designed to help you if you've never done any animation before, get up to speed so that you can take part in our annual animation competition. What we're looking at today is lighting. Lighting is really important in filmmaking. You can make it feel bright or dark, and that really influences how your characters might feel or how you feel about your characters. If you looked at the helpful tip number 1 about storyboarding, you will know that we're going to make a little animation about a cotton reel and a pot of paint. I'm just looking at them. I'm probably going to make my film on this desktop. I was looking at it and thinking, it looks a bit boring. What can I do about that? Well, there's several things that lighting can do to sort that out. Firstly, if you've got any windows near where you're working, it's worth drawing the curtains, because when the sun moves, the shadows also move. And you will probably find that if you're spending a couple of hours animating, the shadows will slowly move, which can be a great effect in its own right, but not ideal if you don't want your shadows to move in your animated film. So draw the curtains and then have a look at the room around you. It's probably darker than you realized. So have a think about whether you need the overhead lights on. But the problem with overhead lights is they're kind of flat and they kind of make things look a bit dull. So the easiest thing that you can do is to get a spotlight, just like this one. One with a head on it that you can sort of move around and change is ideal. It's not absolutely essential, but have a look what happens when I turn it on. Look at the shadows on here, okay? They just become much more pronounced, much clearer. We get some shape on it. And if we play with where the light is, I only have to move the light a little bit and the shadows move. So you can make the shadows long, you can make the shadows short, and you can really play with the lighting and look at your camera or your tablet device that you're doing your animation on and see how it looks through the camera. The way it looks to your eye is one thing, but the way it looks to the camera and the lens is quite another. And that is the most important thing. Look through your camera and look at your screen and get the lighting looking nice. And if you can have 2 angle poise lamps, even better. I mean, you don't want to go around the house taking everybody's bedside light, but a couple will be really, really brilliant. Have one just for more general lighting and one as a sort of more of a spotlight. When you've done that, just make sure that you know where your animation is going to happen and that you've got enough light covering your stage, if you like. My cotton reel is going to run away from my paint pot, and I just need to know that there's enough light covering the action. Once I'm happy with that, I am good to go. So that's the top tip for today. Lighting, use an angle poise lamp, draw the curtains, and you should be all set. Don't forget tomorrow, tip number 4, any more details about entering the competition, about the Morph channel, look in the description, click on the links. There are absolutely no rules to making animation. You can animate anything you want with anything you want. So the most important thing is to have fun. See you again.